Hi there. My name is Bob Plankers. I'm a technical marketing architect with VMware Corporation. Let's talk a little bit about vSGX, or Secure Enclaves. vSGX is virtualized SGX. SGX is the Intel Software Guard extensions, and that's a feature of various Intel CPUs that allow us to create secure enclaves or secure repositories for our secrets, secrets that we keep in applications and such. What secrets might we have? Well, cryptographic keys are the big one that comes to my mind, but you know, it could be HR records, it could be the locations of my secret bases, whatever, you know. With traditional hardware and traditional virtualization up until this point, what we've had is an application running inside of a guest OS, running inside of a hypervisor on a piece of hardware. Makes a lot of sense, right? That application has a secret. Well, and that secret is really held in memory. You know, everything in, on a piece of hardware is held in memory. But to get to that secret, to get to that memory, you have to traverse a couple of different layers. You know, the application talks to the guest OS. The guest OS can see into the secret, right? You know, I guess into the secret. The ESXi can see into the secret. And as far as a risk sort of thing, even though we trust ESXi completely, it's the most secure hypervisor around, and our guest OS is properly patched or are doing pretty well as well, it's just extra components we don't necessarily want to have access. So if we use SGX, vSGX on a VM, we turn that on, and then these boundaries become hard. All of a sudden, these layers can't see in anymore. And that prevents the guest OS. Something happens to the guest OS and an intruder is in there. It can't see. They are not going to be able to see that. ESXi, again, if something should happen, somebody can't see inside of that. It's just between the application and the hardware itself. There's a few caveats here. A wise man once said that there isn't such a thing as a free lunch. Well, that's true. You need vSphere 7 or above. You need hardware, VM hardware, version 17 and above as well. This also impacts the application design as far as vMotion is concerned. Because ESXi is the thing that vMotions VMs around, and it can't see into the secret, it can't move it somewhere else. So in order to do maintenance, to do normal lifecycle operations, you're going to have to take that into account. It's not an insurmountable problem, just something to consider. Last, this is a very CPU feature-dependent feature. The hardware itself needs to support it, and there's only a certain number and type of CPUs that allow this and that have this functionality. Definitely check the VMware, the vSphere compatibility guide, or what we often call the HCL, the hardware compatibility guide. Also, Intel has got a website, ark.intel.com, which will tell you all of the features available in the CPUs you have or might be looking to acquire. For more information, you can check out our blogs, blogs.vmware.com/vSphere. You can also go to vSphereCentral.vmware.com for lots of information about security and vSphere features in general. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.